Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Dear friends in Christ Jesus, do you remember as a child you were told how to share with others? If we were selfish, we were punished. I usually heard, if you will not share with your brother or sister, then you will not play. Parents want their children not to be selfish. They want their children to be giving. Tonight, our Heavenly Father expects the same from us. Tonight, we hear that He shares with us the greatest of all gifts. He shares with us His only begotten Son, Jesus. And Jesus Himself gives to us His body and blood unselfishly. How are we to receive from Him, though? This evening, you will hear His answer to that question as the Lord calls to each of you, saying, "Let's meet at the Lord's table." Our text begins tonight at verse 16 by saying these words. It's not the cup of thanksgiving for which we give thanks a participation in the blood of Christ, and is not the bread that we break a participation in the body of Christ. What is this cup of thanksgiving? Well, this cup of thanksgiving refers to the Passover meal of which Jesus is celebrating with the 12. Jesus is celebrating with the 12, and we see this celebration occurring in three of the Gospels, in Matthew chapter 26, in Mark chapter 14, and in Luke chapter 22. The cup of thanksgiving was the cup of blessing. It was a shared cup of wine that was the last of the three cups to be shared. This last cup, the cup of the blessing, is where Jesus institutes the New Testament in His blood. You will hear that verb tonight as we institute His body and blood in the communion liturgy. And what is this bread that we break? Well, this bread that we break also connects us to the Passover. It's the portion of the bread that's left over after the meal. Jesus uses this bread to shift the attention of His disciples away from the Passover lamb to the true Paschal lamb, Himself. So what is meant by this word, participation? The Greek word is koinonia. Koinonia is a word that describes the blessings of God that He shares with us, and His blessings that we are to share with each other. As you heard in the sermon last Sunday, we have koinonia, we have fellowship with God vertically, and we have fellowship or koinonia with each other horizontally. The King James Version of our Bible uses the word communion, of where we get the term Holy Communion. In other words, we share that which we have in common. So what do we have in common? My friends, as His children, as His loved ones, we have His body and we have His blood. We have salvation won for us by Him. So what's the point, you may ask? And there are many Christians who do ask this question. So what's the point? Paul is saying that when you receive His body and blood, you are actually sharing in Christ's body and blood. Your Heavenly Father is sharing with each one of you the blessings of forgiveness, the blessing of eternal life, the blessing of salvation, all of which Jesus earned for each of us when He gave His body and poured out His blood. It's also very important for us to realize what Paul does not say. Paul does not say that this cup signifies, and Paul does not say that this cup becomes. Paul takes God at his word, and Paul believes. God uses the sacrament to share with us the life-saving spiritual food of our Lord's body and blood. And this is why in the Lutheran Church, Missouri Synod, and this is why in the early church, the practice was always closed communion. The practice of the church from the very beginning, as instituted by Jesus himself, was closed communion. Again, many Christians ask that question, so what's the point? Here's the point. My friends, we cannot. We must not share the body of Christ. We cannot. We must not share the blood of Christ with those who do not believe that Jesus is present. We cannot. We must not share the body and blood with those who believe that Jesus, who is God, is confined to heaven. We cannot and we must not share the body and blood with those who believe that this meal, which you will receive, is not for the forgiveness of sins, when Jesus himself says explicitly that it is. We cannot and we must not share our confession with those who teach falsely. Paul says later, as he writes to the Corinthians, you cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of demons too. You cannot have a part in both the Lord's table and the table of demons. Dear friends, we must resist. We must resist mixing with those who worship falsely. Their worship is false, and it is clear. It is in clear violation of his word, of his command, and of his testament. Verse 17. Because there is one loaf, we who are many are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. Because there is one loaf, our Lord, we who are individuals become one body. It is Christ who joins himself to us, and he joins each of us to him. Not only that, he joins you and me together also because of what he has done for us. What Jesus joins together becomes one body, becomes one loaf. This fellowship is so important that we must realize that joining with those who do not believe in a real presence, who do not have fellowship with Jesus. How can we join ourselves who do not have fellowship with our Lord? Therefore, since they do not have fellowship with Jesus, they don't believe he's present, how can we have fellowship with them? They are not of the same loaf, is what Paul is essentially saying. But they are of another loaf. Once again, the one loaf is our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So therefore, here's the answer to their question, what's the point? Either one believes that Jesus is present, that he is the one loaf, that he is the cup of blessing, or they don't. It's not about what we think, or it's not about what we feel. It's about what God teaches and what he expects of us. So now, my friends, you who are of the one loaf, you who are of the cup of blessing, you are now invited, tenderly invited to partake of the one loaf and that cup of blessing, the body and blood of your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Dear friends, as you now come to eat and drink, I pray that you believe with all your heart that the blessings that you will soon receive, his holy meal, are yours. The blessings of life and salvation, the blessings of his body and blood for the strengthening of your faith, the blessed assurance that all your sins are forgiven, washed away in the blood of the Lamb. We who are in koinonia with our Lord and in koinonia with Him, we truly believe that at this table, He is here to serve us, and He is here to serve us until He returns on that great last day, when we will be with Him forever in His kingdom. Thanks be to Jesus. Amen.